Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl Lisa from Smooch's Makeup Artistry. I wanted to bring to you today this look that you see here. I'm dedicating this to my girl Leah, so hopefully you can rock this at the ball. If you guys are interested in seeing how I created this look, stay tuned. And always remember, you don't have to use the products that I list. Find something similar and make it work for you. Because I use a variety of products, some high-end, some low-end. It really doesn't matter. Use what works for you, and don't feel pressured to have to go out and buy the things that I have, okay? So, smooches. And what I'll also do, if you guys want to know any alternatives to help create this look, just hit me up and I will let you know that. Thank you guys again. Stay tuned. Okay guys, let's get started. I'm going to prime my face with Max Prep and Prime, and this is the Skin Base Visage. I'm going to take a few drops of that and I'm going to apply that evenly all over my skin. What that is doing is setting my skin and preparing it for foundation. It's also reducing some of the redness. It's going to create a surface for a smooth application. I'm now moving on to my brows, and I'm using Max Brow Pencil in Spiked. I am just outlining and going with the natural shape of my brow, and instead of filling it in with a solid line, I am feathering my pencil so it will give the brow an actual natural look. Okay, now I do want to make sure that it's a little bit cleaned up, so I'm using the concealer, which is NYX Above and Beyond Concealer, and I'm going to apply that with a concealer brush, and that is in the color Tan. I'm just going to outline my eyebrow with that, and that's just going to create a sharper look. Okay, I'm going to now set my brows with e.l.f. Brow Setting Gel. And I'm moving on to my eyes. I'm going to prime that with MAC's Paint Pot. And that color is Painterly. I'm applying that all over the lid. That is going to create a base for my eyeshadows. I'm using my Naked palette, and I'm going to use the color Version. And I'm going to apply that all over my lid. Next, I'm going into my MAC palette, and I'm taking the color Brown Script, and I'm applying that in my crease, and I'm going a little bit above the crease. And now I'm going to go back in that same palette, and I'm picking up that color Ground Brown. I'm applying that directly in my crease, and basically that is going to give a little bit more dimension to the eye, and it's going to kind of be like a cut crease, but I'm going to soften it right now with the blending brush. Now moving on to my waterline, I'm using MAC's Kohl pencil, and that color is Feline. And right there, I'm just taking a little angled brush and just blending that Feline out. I'm going to use Sephora's eyeliner cream, and this is in the color, it's called Must Have. Basically, in order to apply liner, normally just do soft strokes, soft short strokes. I'm now going to apply my lashes. A dollar, y'all. My dollar lashes from e.l.f. They are the natural pair, so it's just going to add a little bit more length to my lashes. I'm going to use my duo glue, and basically I'm just going to put a little bit of that glue on my hand. I don't want to apply the glue directly to the lashes because that can be very messy. You want to take your tweezers and lightly dip the lash in the glue. You want to make sure that it is coated from beginning to end, but not drenched, okay? And you want to give it about a minute to make the glue tacky, because you don't want to put it on while the glue is super wet, okay? And I'm sorry, y'all, I thought that you guys would be able to see me, but all you see is the top of my big head. But yeah, I'm also using my hands as well to apply the lash. Just trying to get it as close to my lash line as possible. And while I get the other one to dry, I'm going to put on my mascara. Now, y'all, my camera died, so I'm back. What can you do? My lashes are done. Sorry you guys missed it. I'm going to move on to foundation. And I'm using my MAC Studio Fix foundation. And my color is NW43. I'm going to apply that with a kabuki brush. And I'm also applying that in circular motion. What that is going to do is give it an airbrushed look. Excuse my voice, y'all. It is almost 2 a.m. in the morning. And I am doing a voiceover recording for this. Now I am applying my concealer right under my eyes. That's just going to serve as a highlight. And now I'm going to just set everything with my MAC Prep and Prime Transparent Finishing Powder. Onto my cheeks, I'm going to use my Sculpting Powder just to define the cheeks a little bit. And I'm going to put that right in the crease. It is called Definitive is the color. And I'm just going to contour just lightly around my face to add some dimension to it. And that is MAC's blush in Frankly Scarlet. Now, you're going to be really careful when you apply this. You only need a little bit. Otherwise, you'll be looking like a clown. Onto the lips, I'm using MAC's pencil in Beet. I'm applying that all over my lip. That is going to be the base for my Ruby Woo. Hands down, favorite red from MAC. I'm going to apply that all over my lip. It is a matte color. You are more than welcome to apply a gloss on top of it if you don't like matte lips, but I absolutely adore them.
Thumbs me up. Please subscribe if you have not done so already. Thank you guys again so much. Be blessed, and most importantly, be a blessing. Smooches.